Give you all the glory, Jesus. We worship your name, Lord. We say you are holy, Jesus. We say you are awesome, Lord. Oh, there is none like unto you, Father. You deserve all the glory this hour. You deserve our worship. You deserve all the adoration in the name of Jesus. Father, we thank you for having taken care of us. We also appreciate you for who you are. Father, we don't worship you because of what you do to us. We worship you because you are our God. And so this particular hour, we are teaming up with the 24 elders in your presence. The four creatures and the angels and camping around you just to appreciate and to honor your name, because we know you are a God and there is none like unto you. Thank you, Father, for preserving our lives. Thank you for fighting our battles. Thank you for contending with those who have contended with us, Abba Father. Thank you even for the gift of life, the hope of eternity. Lord, we say thank you. You alone deserve all the glory, worship, and adoration in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. We have taken some of your 5 minutes, our viewers, and we are so grateful that the Lord has enabled us to come and give you the point number five, or the fifth episode of Money, the Gate of Our Destinies, in the presence of the Lord, in Jesus' name. So as I promised, by the grace of God, I've been handling a topic that the Lord laid in my spirit, that is manning the gate of your destiny, manning the gate of your destiny. It is your destiny. And I've always said, nobody can do it for you. Nobody can do it for you. You know, I look at the scenario of the ministry of Jesus. Jesus knew there is a point that is going to come and I'm going to leave these people. And we see he's impacting into their lives. He's praying for them. He's counseling them. He's cautioning them, you know. He's speaking to their lives because he knew, I'm not going to be with them forever. But he made a promise that is so that is very profound, and he told them, I am going to my Father and I'm going to prepare a place for you, and when everything will be said, I'll come and pick you and bring you where I am. Hallelujah. So we are not just doing this. We are not just here. We are here on a very divine assignment and in a very divine moment in the presence of the Lord, in the name of Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. So I've been saying, the Lord is speaking to the church, even as we pray and do all of the whatever we are doing in our daily lives. The Lord is saying and requesting all of us that we take charge of our destinies. We man the gates of our destinies. Many other times, some of us have been brought up in some traditional homes, you know, where our forefathers or where we grew up. People believe in the things that are not of the Bible, the things that are not of God. And many of us have found ourselves in such kind of foundations. Now, when you come to the knowledge of the truth, you know, that's why the Bible says, it is the truth you know that sets you free. When you come to the knowledge of the truth, the expectation in the heart of God is that now you fit in. And that's what I've been saying, fit in and flow well. Fit in and flow well. Hallelujah. That's why Jesus is saying, you know, these ones you committed to my hands. Whatever you committed to my hands, I have finished. And I have also committed to them. Hallelujah. I've given them an assignment to do. Hallelujah. And I'm not going to leave them as orphans. Jesus is telling the disciples, because he knew here on earth, there are troubles here on earth. There are so many things. And he said, I have already overcome the world. Hallelujah. And you are also more than conquerors in my name. Hallelujah. So what am I saying? It is your personal responsibility to take charge of your life, to take charge of your destiny. It is your destiny. Hallelujah. I look at my life where I grew up, and I have always told people my own personal testimony, and I tell them, in my entire family setup, even from my forefathers and wherever I came from, the roots of where I came from, there has never been a preacher. So I've not received impartation from anybody. I did not have anybody to copy. I thank God for my mother, because when she received Christ in her old age, even after having given birth to us, she took us to the house of God. So it is through that connection of the house of God where whatever God preordained for my life has been realized. I came to know it myself. Hallelujah. I came to know who I am in the Lord myself. I had nobody to copy. Thank God for that platform that my mother gave to me. She took me to the house of the Lord, and it is from there I came to know who I am in the Lord, and I'm living it. Hallelujah. Oh my God. I've always told people, some of us, God commanded us to resign from offices. I thank God for my former bosses. God told some of us, you know, resign, go and do my assignment, go and do this, because this is what I wired you for. This is what I created you for. Hallelujah. And you know, I look at, you know, some of these things we read in the Bible and we wonder whether they still happen. You know, Peter is asking Jesus at one point, now what about us, Jesus? We left, you know, I've always told people, Peter was married. You know, there is a time Jesus went to heal the mother. You know, she was down with the flu, and Jesus passed by there to heal her. Hallelujah. So that man was married. Amen. Now listen to this. It is about the destiny that God has ordained for you. Now it is you to realize, I'm giving you my own personal testimony, that my mother did not even wake up one day. I know she educated me like any other children, and she took me through the process, oh my God, of the accounts and everything. And I thought one day I'm going to be a very big accountant in one of the banks. You know, I really wanted to work with the Barclays Bank and started back with the international banks, because I loved accounts, I loved mathematics. Hallelujah. And that did not come to pass. You know, I began that journey of doing what what I thought I should do in my life, and fitting in and flowing in with what I desired in my life. But at the end of the day, what am I seeing in my life? I'm seeing that God has restructured me. Lord, God has given me a refocus. You know, He has really worked on me, and He has now caused me to fit in to the destiny He preordained from the word of God in the book of Romans chapter 8. There is that which He preordained for my life. Hallelujah. And now that is who I am today, by the grace of God. And I've always even told my children, you know, at one point things were not very good. Hallelujah. Because ministry, oh my God, the things of God is not bread and butter. You know, there is a process of making. That's what I read in the word of God from the beginning. If you look at the life of Joseph, it was not easy for the dream to become a reality, for him to become, I know, that which God preordained for his life. Things were, the process was not very good. And I remember one of my sons telling me, Mama, go back to work. You know, when you are working in the office, we used to have this. Oh, go back to the office. And I told them, no, it's just a matter of time. And God is going to, you know, take us through this process and begin restoring our lives bit by bit, because he is God. I remember even to where I'm seated, my own boss has never resigned my resignation letter, because it was like, Regina, are you nuts? Are you for real? Eh? Are you for real? You are a mother. You know, the way things are, you are still too young. You should work. You know, you need a career. And I'm like, my boss, even what God has called me to be is a better career for my destiny. And I thank God, because when I began the ministry, one of my bosses was one of the people who supported my ministry with some 20 plastic seats. Oh God, hallelujah. Thank you, Holy Spirit. So it is a matter of knowing your destiny, and that you must know it. And that's why I said 2 days ago, even if the prophet prophesied and there is a word, you know, we looked at the word of God from the book of Timothy. Paul is speaking to the son, and he's telling the son, from the word that you have received, the word of the prophecy, this one is going to enable you to fight the right battle, you know, to maneuver your way and to handle the right, you know, the good fight. In this walk of faith, the good warfare, hallelujah, you are able now to use that word of prophecy. And now it is going to enable you to fight the right battles in your life. Hallelujah. So I am talking about manning the gate of your destiny. And at one point when I realized I could not understand what is happening in my life here and there, I did not even fight with my mother or anybody in my family. I went to a prayer mountain, and I was asking God, Father, I'm looking at 1, 2, 3 things. This is not what is supposed to be happening in my life as a child out of God. I took charge of my life, and anytime I see something that is not okay, I take charge of my life. Hallelujah. I don't mean that you don't consult. We have fathers in the Lord. I have a father in the Lord, and you know, but there is that personal connection with your father. And that's why I'm speaking to the church. Let us stop running helter skelter, looking for prophets, looking for people to speak to our lives. You are also a child of God. The same spirit that is within us is the same spirit you have. have as a child of God. Hallelujah. There is no Holy Spirit of members. Oh my God. Whatever we call members, you know, and some of us even say my members. You don't have your members. Hallelujah. Now, that's a story for another day. Now, the Spirit of God is outpoured, you know, He is ministering to all of us. All of us, we are all apart, despite that some of us are in the fivefold ministry, but we are all of us together as members of the body of Jesus Christ. So the same Spirit that is working in the life of Apostle Peter is the same Spirit that is working in somebody who is sweeping in the house of God, a cook, somebody who is doing catering, you know, cooking in the house of God, you know, an usher, hallelujah, somebody who is a Sunday school teacher. That is the same Spirit. Somebody who is going to see the orphans, the widows. That is the same Spirit that is in operation. We don't have a special Holy Spirit. It is just one Spirit. Hallelujah. We are coming from one faith, one God, and one Spirit in the name of Jesus. So man the gate of your destiny, and you're going to enjoy the faithfulness of God in Jesus' name. I said from the word, go, do it violently. The kingdom of God, our kingdom is a kingdom of power. So this kingdom is suffering violence from the beginning, from the days of John the Baptist until now. And it is until you become violent, that's how you take it by force. Hallelujah. That's how you get to your destiny by force in the name of Jesus. And I said, number two, you must be prayerful. You must be a prayerful person. The other thing I said is that we must walk blameless. That is that we must live holy lives. We must be, we must decide to walk in righteousness, do our things in righteousness. Be blameless, be prayerful. Hallelujah. I'm looking at my notes. And the other thing I said yesterday, be consistent. That's how you man the gates of your destiny. Be consistent and persistent. No prophet will come on the ground and do that for you. That is your personal responsibility in the presence of the Lord. So be violent, hallelujah, be blameless, hallelujah, be prayerful, be consistent and persistent in your walk of faith in Jesus' name. Don't be an on and off Christian, hallelujah. Be consistent, love the Lord consistently, walk in holiness consistently, hallelujah. Daniel and the three Hebrew boys, it was so consistent, their walk of faith was so consistent in the presence of the Lord. It does not matter who is going to fall off, purpose in your heart that you're going to live a holy life. Even if you are alone in Jesus' name. And I've been saying, even if you have fallen short of the glory of God, the Bible says, we have all sinned and fallen short of the glory of God. Reconcile yourself back to the presence of your Father in the name of Jesus. So tonight, for a few minutes, I want to speak about the last one for now, as the Spirit of God has enabled you, has enabled me, and I'm speaking about sacrificially. Man, the gate of your destiny, sacrificially. Hallelujah. Church, are you hearing this? You must sacrifice. You know, as I was preparing and meditating on this word, I was hearing in the Spirit of God that our lives are full of sacrifice. You know, your life is a sacrifice by itself. Hallelujah. Now, I look at the way... you know, I love what Solomon is saying, even about the people who just want to sleep, you know, the people who don't want to work hard, you know, he's requesting us to go and look at that ant, you know, the way the ant labors, you know, we all of us know the ant, and we know how that thing is very small, and we know the way that thing is very hard working. Hallelujah. Nothing comes easy. I began by saying from the word go, your life or your destiny is a prophecy by itself. Hallelujah. That's why the Bible says we were predestined. God called us, you know, He chose us before time. Even that's why He's telling Jeremiah, even before you are conceived in your mother's womb, I foreknew you. Hallelujah. I had already ordained you. So our ordination, all our calling the Lord, even you are being born again now, it is not an accident. It was desired. It was designed even before your mother and your father thought of getting a child in their life. Hallelujah. And that's why you realize in your family, everybody may not be born again, but God has had picked you. Hallelujah. Not everybody in your company is born again, but in that company you work, you realize that God has deposited something in you. He has just had picked you and set you apart for His own glory in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. So let us do this sacrificially. Man, the gate of you haramahando robo zia. Oh my God, this one has to be done sacrificially. Hallelujah. And that is to mean that we are going to do all. We are going to do all in a sacrificial manner. What does that mean? We must give up, we must live a life that is where we are giving up what we think is valuable to us as human beings, what we think is very important to us as human beings, and you know, what you think is very important. Hallelujah. What you think, you give it up. You give it up so that you may fit into that which is the purposes of God in your life. I love what the Bible says in the book of Isaiah, that God caused the end from the beginning. He knows the end from the beginning. Hallelujah. That's why John the Revelator is saying he is the beginning and the end. Aramahandorobozia. He was there in the beginning. Hallelujah. He's the ancient of day. He has been there. He's there. Hallelujah. He's the beginning and the end. He's the Alpha and Omega. Hallelujah. So we give up. The Lord is calling upon each one of us. Let us give up. You know, so many of us are educated. We are also there. We think we have so many things. We think we have acquired so much that we don't have value for God. I have realized something, and I now know why David was praying that God may give him just enough that is not going to drift him away from the presence of the Lord. Hallelujah. So the Lord is saying, man the gate of your destiny sacrificially. Hallelujah. Give up what you think is very important to you as a human being that is not in line with the purposes of God for your destiny. That even, oh my God of all glory. Hallelujah. We are seeing people like Abraham. Oh my God. He's saying to the nephew, Roti, you are my relative, yes, but a time has come I must take charge of my destiny. There is somewhere when God called me, there is somewhere he was taking me, and I cannot live in strife. Taking charge of your destiny sacrificially, that means you can give up any, you can give up anything that seems to be very important, that seems to be very, you know, that it seems to be very variable in your life as a human being, and you know it is outside the word of God. It is outside the counsel of God. I love what the Bible says about the birth of Jesus Christ and his growth, about the spirit of revelation, you know, the spirit of counsel, the spirit of might, the spirit of wisdom, the spirit of understanding, the spirit of knowledge. You know, all these spirits were in him. Hallelujah. This Jesus is in us the hope of glory. So anything that is removing you from the counsel of God, anything that is diverting your life from the wisdom of God, anything you think is valuable, that's why Jesus was calling the disciples and he was telling them, leave this, follow me and I will make you. The Lord is calling each one of us today to take charge of our destinies sacrificially. Let us forsake anything that is not godly, anything that is not Ramahandorobozia, anything that has been stagnating you, anything that has been pulling you back from becoming that which God ordained for your life. And it could be anything. You know, I'm looking at the word of God in the book of Matthew one time, and even in the book of Mark chapter 10 from verse 28 down there. You know, one time Peter is going to Jesus, and you know, amid his other disciples, and he's asking Jesus, what about us who left our all and we followed you? Oh my God of all glory, there is no loss in following Christ. And Jesus is telling them, here on earth, anybody including you and me, those who have left their mothers, those who have left their sisters, my Jehovah God, so that they can follow me, those who have left their houses and their lands and everything, so that I know of people who left their countries. God sent them to foreign countries so that they can serve them. I mean, so that they can serve him. Hallelujah. I know people who have left things. Some of us have left jobs, you know, whatever we call jobs and careers. Oh my God of all glory, so that we can fit in to that which God has called us to do. And Jesus is telling Peter, oh my God, now you are going to receive a reward of the same. In my kingdom, you'll have the mothers, you'll have the sisters, you'll have the brothers, you'll have all those things. And Jesus is saying, inherited folds, hallelujah. Even lands, oh my God of all grace, hallelujah. Oh, hallelujah. So we have not lost it. We have not missed the way. So what am I saying? The Lord is saying, the last point for this hour, man the gate of your destiny sacrificially. Your life is a whole sacrifice by itself. Hallelujah. That's what Paul is saying in Romans chapter 12. We give our bodies as living sacrifices, holy and acceptable to God. Hallelujah. Your body could be pushing you to something that your brothers and your sisters love doing, but because you are a set apart, you realize that you cannot fit there. That is what we are seeing in the life of Gideon. When God set him apart for an assignment, he could not watch. Many all the years Gideon had lived, he had not had the authority to deal with the altars of and the gods of his father's household. But this particular moment, because he has come to the knowledge of the truth, he is now set apart. He's disconnecting himself and he's saying, it cannot continue being like this, because I have now known the truth and have been set apart for the glory of God. Hallelujah. And he's destroying the gods of his fathers at night. Hallelujah. And yesterday I said, wisdom is key, even as we do the operations of the Lord. Oh no, he evaded the warfare that would have come against his life that was not very necessary. Oh, hallelujah. And I thank God for the father, for the father of Gideon. He said, you know, when people say this must be Gideon, oh, the father said, if that God you worship be God, let him defend him. Oh, hallelujah. Now, we are giving up the characters that are not godly. We are giving up the kind of dressing codes. We are giving up the kind of speeches. We are giving up the kind of connections and relationships, my Jehovah God. I've always told girls and boys, particularly in these early times, the people who think they can have, like the people of the world, you can have the boyfriend and girlfriend. Oh, my Jehovah God. These things, I know. I've been counseling even girls who are living on family planning pews. They are in high school. They already know these things. You know, my God, when we were growing up, no, that old time salvation, there are things, some of us, there are things even at this particular age, when we are 40 plus, there are things we cannot do. There are things we cannot do, whether somebody is watching us or not watching us. Hallelujah. So you give your body. You know your body is a temple of God. And the Bible is saying whoever destroys the temple, God will also destroy them. Hallelujah. So you man the gate of your destiny, where you are saying like Joseph, I am going to sacrifice. I'm going to live a holy life. My father Jacob is not with me here in this Potiphar's house. My boss Potiphar cannot even see me. But I cannot mess up my integrity. I cannot to sell up my integrity. Daniel, Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego, they are saying in Babylon, this kind of food that is sacrificed to idols, we do not eat. Let everybody eat the sausages. Let everybody eat whatever they are eating. We are good to go with the vegetables. We are good to go. Hallelujah. Now, sacrifice for the sake of your destiny. Hallelujah. Give up that thing everybody is saying in your family is good. Oh my God, it is so pain in my spirit to see so many people in Africa are going back to traditions, even people who are born again and speak in tongues. And I keep on wondering, my Jehovah God, haven't we read the word of God in the book of 1 Chronicles about a story of a man called Jabez? Jabez sacrificed. He said, I know maybe the tradition of my mother allowed her to give me a name that has caused me a lot of pain. Maybe that was her tradition. Maybe that is because of where she came from. Hallelujah. But when Jabez, he was very honorable, even among us, the other brothers. But he realized, oh my, he came back, you know, the way you can just like wake up from sleep and from slumber. And he realized, no, my life is not ordained to follow in the traditions of my mother. Whether she bore me in pain or whatever, I will not fit in there. So I feel mercy for the people who are following the traditions of men. God, today the Lord was speaking to my spirit and he told me, daughter, I am not a traditionalist. I am not. Hallelujah, where people are going back to traditions that are not written in the word of God. As a child of God, separate yourself from the traditions of men. It does not matter. One time there's something that was meant to go on in my family, and one of the people called me and asked me, so where do you belong? What do you think will happen to your life? Blah blah, because you don't want to be a part of the family. I told them I belong to the family of the lion of the tribe of the lion of Judah. Hallelujah. I know what we are supposed to do. I know what you are supposed to do. Hallelujah. And God spoke to me and told me, daughter, you and your children, you are set apart. You have been delivered from all these evil things. I don't have to pray. And that's why I said in that day of this ministration, I said, it is no time to be a man priest. Stop priesting people. Hallelujah. It is so pathetic.
Oh my God, I'm seeing people even in the church going back even to putting on some kind of garments of traditions because they want to flow with the currency that is flowing on right now. I came to say the only currency you're supposed to be flowing in is the reading of the Spirit of God. Hallelujah. That is where our reading is coming from. That's why the Bible says, as many as are read by the Spirit of God, not people who have been led by the counsel and the traditions of men. Hallelujah. These kind of people, they don't have part in the kingdom of God in the name of Jesus. So the Lord is speaking to us, let us sacrifice. Let us do all. Let us think all. Let us decide all. That is, in all the circumstances, like a job, in all the situations, we are going to sacrifice. This is where we say no. When our God is saying no, this is what I said yesterday. When he says yes, we say it is yes. If our God is saying it is white and everybody else is saying it is blue, you start by the side of God and say, I am saying what my Father is saying in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. We are not going to cow down. We are not going to be misled. Avoid being misled. And that's why I'm speaking to the church, all of us. Hallelujah. I am saying the Bible says, test every spirit, including our servants of God. Test whatever kind of a spirit we are ministering to you with. Hallelujah. Because I'm telling you, in heaven, the Bible says, every knee shall bow. Do not go before God and tell God, so and so told me to do this. And because he said he was a man or a woman of God, that's why there will be no such opportunity, my brethren. Hallelujah. So sacrifice for you. Your life. Let be called a fool. Be called a fool. Hallelujah. It looked very foolish for Daniel, you know, even to go to an extent of going down the lion's den. And everybody in the nation is watching, including the king. It looked a fool. Hallelujah. It looked very foolish for Esther, my Jehovah, after sacrifice for her people for 3 days fasting and praying. It looked very foolish, maybe to other people, you know, to the people who knew the traditions of that time. And, she said, if I perish, I perish. Hallelujah. Sacrifice. Hallelujah. And I want everybody watching me to know, and everybody who is going to hear this to know, when you sacrifice something and it is in the course of the direction of God, you will never be ashamed. Hallelujah. God will never ashamed you in his mighty name, in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. So what is the Lord saying tonight? What is the Lord saying tonight? I'm going to be very fast. The Lord is returning us to Deuteronomy chapter 6 and verse 5. The Lord is returning us to Deuteronomy chapter 6 and verse 5, where the Bible is saying, you know, God was speaking to the children of Israel, and he told them, love the Lord your God. He was speaking through Moses, love the Lord your God with all your heart. Oh my God. Because in your heart is where comes the issues of life. Hallelujah. It's from the abundance of the heart, even your mouth speaketh. Hallelujah. Show me the things you are saying and the things you are doing. They will reflect your heart. Oh my God. By the way, your lifestyle reflects your heart. Your attitude and everything about you reflect your heart. Hallelujah. You cannot say you have a good heart. Your heart is good. And when we look at your character outside here, it's betraying you. That is reflecting your heart. Hallelujah. So he's telling them, love the Lord God with all your heart, with all your soul, with all your strength. Hallelujah. And this is where even the resources come in. Hallelujah. You know, I've always told people, there are people who are very stingy, even to God. You know, there is a notion that has come in these end times. They are calling it the gospel of grace. I don't know where this gospel of grace is coming from. My God of all grace. Hallelujah. That people should not pay tithe. People should not give, their tithe. Now, what is happening in these end times in the New Testament is that it is not about the role. It is about, you know, the love you have. You know, nobody is pushing you. There is nobody is controlling you. You cheer for a gift. But from what you get in your life, what you labor with your strength, God is a partaker of that. That is why you must love him with your strength. Hallelujah. Nobody is monitoring you. Nobody is, oh my God, some of us are tithers and nobody can move me from there because I have seen God. I have seen God. I have taught my children, even my physical children, even my ministry. We tithe. Those people who are fighting the ministry of tithing, and it's not about that figure. We do exceedingly abundantly because that is the nature of our God. Hallelujah. We sow, we give. Oh my God. And we enjoy the favor of God in the name of Jesus. Amen. So This is where the Lord is taking us back to. That shows us, church, let us be sold out to Him. You know, many other times we sing these songs. Now, it is not about what we sing. It is not about the actual thing. That's why I have been saying that our God is reality. He is active. He is present. He is reliable. Hallelujah. He's very faithful. Let us attain the DNA of our Father for Lil. Let us be sold out to Him. Let us fit in. Hallelujah. Let us surrender our all. Not singing, I surrender, Lord. Oh, when you surrender, Lord, and when your life is surrendered all, this is where you only say what He says or what you hear Him say. This is where you do only that which you hear Him do, not what your traditionalists are telling you to do or not what people are telling you to do. You sit back and you say, Holy Spirit of God, what do I do here? Which formula do I apply here? And that is where the church must get back to, because we are in the season where God has come to manifest the sons in the name of Jesus Christ. Now, the Lord they're saying we must make Him our priority. Oh, make God your priority. That means as you think, as you desire, as you purpose, everything is going to fit in to that which is the heartbeat of God. So every moment of your life, you'll be purposing to know what is God saying concerning this, even concerning our nations, particularly concerning my country, Kenya. I love my country so much. Hallelujah. We must purpose to know. Everybody could be saying this. The TVs could be saying this. And that's why I've been telling the Church of Jesus Christ in these early times, please don't wait for the devil to give you prayer points from the TV. Don't wait for the devil and the kingdom of darkness to give you prayer points from their kingdom and from their platforms. Hallelujah. You should be prayed up. Hallelujah. You should be downloading, even God, because God is able even to reveal what the devil is purposing from His kingdom, from the comfort of your house. And I told you these things from the beginning. Hallelujah. What are you seeing? This is the formula God has given us. You know, when I read the word of God, I'm going to be very fast. The Bible says in Matthew 6 and verse 32b that, you know, the heathen are running after all those things. They run after lands. They run after houses. They run after good, beautiful women. Oh my God. That is what they live for. But the Bible is saying that your Father in heaven, this is what Jesus is telling the disciples who have left everything to follow Him. He's telling them that your Father in heaven knows that you need all these things. Not one thing. My brother, God knows you need a beautiful wife. God knows you need a handsome husband. God knows you need a nice car. God knows you need, and that's why the Bible says, until you get to that level of maturity, that stage of maturity, whatever belongs to you is still in the hands of custodians, guardians, until you mature. Oh my God, where my Jehovah, even if God gives you a Range Rover, whatever nice car you desire in your life, my Jehovah, you are not going to move. Actually, the more God is elevating you, even with the material possessions, is the more you are going to humble in His presence and you follow Him. Hallelujah. Amen. So our formula is in Matthew 6 and verse 33. This is our formula, that we seek first His kingdom. His kingdom is righteousness, peace, and joy in the Holy Ghost. We seek that component first, and His righteousness, and all other things. When the Bible is saying all, when Jesus is saying all, He means all, including an onion that you need in your house, including a matchbox. Hallelujah. Women, including a nice hairdo. And I've always told the women, you don't have to compromise your faith. Hallelujah. Oh my God. You should look for some of us. We live by faith. Hallelujah. You don't have to lower your salary for a promotion. God knows that you need it. And when you need it, because He's a father and you are an all-time son, that is what I said yesterday. Be an all-time son to your Father. So when you call upon His name, He's going to appear. He's going to act. He's going to hear, because you're not a technical believer in the presence of the Lord. Hallelujah. So our formula is, let us give our bodies. Our bodies are the temples of God. That means God indwells us. Let us let these bodies. That means my life as a child of God, I cannot be controlled by the traditions of my people. I cannot be controlled by the desires of my friends. Hallelujah. I cannot fit in to that. Thank you, Holy Spirit. I hear the Spirit of God say, you desist fitting in to that which is humanly instigated. You desist as a servant of God. I've been counseling with so many people who followed some people, even some fathers in the Lord in the world, and that they ended up being taken or introduced to some demonic altars. And I have always said, if I were the one, I would have done it the Joseph way. I would have left the court there. Let that man, a father or a mother in the Lord, be left with that, because that is not my direction. And we are seeing so many destinies messed up, even in the ministry, because somebody is not able to say no. The Bible says we say no to any manner of ungodliness, free from any mention of evil. Hallelujah. Any mention of evil. Now, this is where the sacrificial living, the sacrificial manning of the gate of your destiny is coming from tonight in the name, or whatever time it is in your country, in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Matthew 16 and verse 26, I'm finishing. Now, God is concerned. We are seeing that God is concerned about our lives here, not only in heaven. God, that is what we are seeing from the ministration of Jesus Christ. Now, I'm requesting, because we know that, let us lay our treasures in heaven. And I want to let the church know that where your heart is, that is where, I mean, where your treasures are, that is where your heart is. Amen. That's why I'm saying, let us go back to loving the Lord genuinely. Be authentic. Be genuine. Love the Lord with your everything, with your soul, with your heart, with your might. That means you can give God your all. If God says, clear your wardrobe, you clear. If God says, clear your house, you clear. That's what we are seeing in the life of our father of faith, Abraham. Give your honor, sacrifice your honor. Hallelujah. And Abraham is not like, God, I have been waiting for a very long time. It is now my time to enjoy and pamper my only son. No. Hallelujah. It is, if God has said it and I've waited for a long time and he has given it to me, because it, me and all these things belong to him. So I have nothing to hold. Hallelujah. Some of us, our hands are always very open. If God says, dash and do 1, 2, 3, and give this to that person, even if it is a car I bought yesterday, you just give it out by the grace of God in Jesus' name. Amen. Because our faith in him is greater than the possession or the material things in the name of Jesus. So the Lord is asking the church to refocus. Church, refocus. For you to get to the destiny he ordained for you, sacrificially, you must sacrificially man that gate. Hallelujah. Refocus from this hour, refocus. So that you are able to get the attention of your father as a son. Amen. So many of us, I hear the Spirit of God say, many of us are overcrowded. We are overcrowded by what people have said. We want to please this. We want to please that. My Jehovah God, oh my God, it is not time to please people. It is time to please God. Love him with your soul. Love him with your heart. Love him with your might. My Jehovah, if it is to step down from that particular office, let it be so, if God has ordained it to be that way. Hallelujah. Because if Jesus came when you are still in a mess like that, my Jehovah, eternity will be history in your life in Jesus' name. And in this particular end times, we are going to sacrifice more. We are going to sacrifice that our time. We see that even in the Garden of Gethsemane. Jesus is asking the disciples, you cannot tarry with me even for an hour. Hallelujah. And he's telling them, pray that you may not enter into temptation, my God. Now, this is, and he's telling them, the Spirit of God is willing, but the flesh is not for the idea. That is calling for sacrifice. Even prayer, what I said yesterday but one, it is a sacrifice. Hallelujah. Fasting is a sacrifice. Hallelujah. Because everybody, oh my God, you don't want to eat meat like any other person. Oh my God, my Jehovah God, you don't want to go into some of these places like any other person. But my Jehovah God, you realize the Spirit of God is containing you. Hallelujah. And containing you. And I've always looked at the life of Jesus and his ministry. That, you know, one time the sons of Zebedee, you know, the mother is making a request, and Jesus is asking, are you able to drink from the cup I'm going to drink from? Hallelujah. And he's even telling them, you know, even the birds of the air have nests. Hallelujah. But the Son of Man has nowhere to lay his head. Meaning Jesus had not even put up a house anywhere for himself. When he didn't have the Passover with his disciples, there is an inn, go ahead, there is this. Means of transport, go to the village ahead of us. There is a cot tied there. Oh my God of all glory. Hallelujah. I love the ministry of Jesus Christ. So the things we are holding on, they are not very valuable than the God we believe in the name of Jesus. So what am I saying tonight? Esther sacrificed and she got brought fruits. Nehemiah sacrificed, and even the people God brought into the life of Nehemiah, they were able to hold the armor on one side and the tool of work on one side. Sacrifice. And we see them getting the result or the fruits of their labor in the name of Jesus. That's why the Bible says, say to the righteous, Isaiah 3 and verse 10, they are going to eat the fruit of their labor. Hallelujah. And so I'm saying to the righteous, anything you have done, you have sacrificed. Hallelujah. You have said no to fornication, even when there was an opportunity. You have said no to getting business through bribery, even when there was an opportunity. And maybe now even your business is down because you have refused to give in to the standard of this world. I came to say, tables are turned. Tables are turned. Hallelujah. The wicked have been piling their wealth in their wickedness for the sake of the righteous. Hallelujah. Our Father in heaven knows that we need all these things. And I came to say tonight, or whatever time it is in your country, it is about time that our Father adds to arise all these things in Jesus' name. I'm saying our Father is about to add all things. He's going to use anything and anybody to make sure what you need in your life is added by the grace of God in Jesus' name. So just like Jabez, refuse to fit in. Don't avoid confrontational issues. Avoid to fit in to that which is not the ready standard of your life by God in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Take charge of the gate of your destiny. Man, the gate of your destiny. If it calls for fasting, fast. If it calls for praying, pray. If it calls for giving something tangible, money or something, a suit or something, oh my God, a seat in your house, please do it. Sacrifice. Hallelujah. Man, the gate of your destiny. Physically, spiritually, socially, whatever, psychologically, materially, man, the gate of your destiny. Sacrificially in Jesus' name. We are seeing Gideon enjoying the fruit. We are seeing Nehemiah enjoying the fruit. We are seeing Jesus enjoying the fruit. And we are seeing even his disciples enjoying the fruit in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. God bless you. I want to the scripture quickly in Matthew. In the book of Mark chapter 10. Mark chapter 10, I'm here, Mark chapter 10, verse 28. Mark chapter 10 and verse 28. So the Bible says, then Peter began to say to him, see, we have left all and followed you. So Jesus answered and said to him, assuredly I say to you, there is no one who has left house or brothers or sisters or father or mother or wife or children or lands for my sake and the gospels, who shall not receive hundredfold now in this time. Ramahandorobozia. Oh, church, are you hearing this? I know you are saying, I left this. That Jesus is saying, none of those who did that, who is not going to receive a hundredfold now in this time. So from tonight, we are claiming whatever we have sacrificially left so that we may preach the gospel. Hallelujah. For the sake of eternity, for the sake of righteousness and holiness. Now we should claim with this scripture, because the Bible is saying these people are going to receive in this life a hundredfold. Hallelujah. Houses and brothers and sisters and mothers and children and lands with the persecution. It is all right. Hallelujah. We shall receive this. And there is that kachumbari or roiko that is being added there. Persecution. And in the age to come, eternal life. Hallelujah. So we are good to go by the grace of God. Amen. So lastly, the point number 5, the 5th episode of Manning Your Destiny. The Lord is speaking to the church. Apart from violently doing it, living a blameless life, being prayerful, being consistent and persistent, the last thing I'm going to speak about and I've spoken about tonight, the Lord is speaking to the church. Do that sacrificially. Hallelujah. When you're supposed to wake up and pray for your destiny, pray. When you're supposed to give a prophetic seed, give and let the Lord order yourselves to the right prophetic grace that is holding the key to your destiny or the word for your destiny in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Even for our nations, let us do it. Hallelujah. Let us do whatever, man the gates of our destiny sacrificially by the grace of God in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Hallelujah, church. So that is the word of the Lord. So let me remind you, thank you, Holy Spirit. The Spirit of God is telling me to remind you the 5 points. So man the gate of your destiny violently. Number 2, man the gate of your destiny by living a blameless life or walking a blameless walk in the presence of the Lord, because your destiny is going to fit in or to flow in with the standard of God. Number 3, be prayerful. Have a prayerful walk Be prayerful. Do it without ceasing. Hallelujah. Number four. Be consistent, and persistent in your walk of faith. Don't be an on and off son. Be consistent and persistent. And number five for this hour, is the Lord is saying, do it sacrificially. Hallelujah. Give up what you think you value or what is very important to you that could be a mess to your walk of, to your destiny in the, or a hindrance. Thank you, Holy Spirit, to your destiny in the name of Jesus. I finish by saying, it is your destiny. And if God be for you, nothing should be against you as a child of God in Jesus' name. I hear the Lord say, I remind you the scripture that is saying, Jesus is saying, I have overcome the world. You know, he said, I have finished it all. You know, he finished it all. Now the Lord is reminding us scripture. Now we are more than conquerors. Hallelujah. We are seated with him in heavenly places. So whatever is happening around here or whatever is happening in this world, it should not dictate how we shall be as children of God. Go read for yourself and study keenly. Genesis chapter 26. Whether it is raining, whether it is sunny, that is, should not be controlling our lives. Hallelujah. Because we are seated with Christ in heavenly places. So let us do things and handle things from where we are seated as ambassadors of Christ in this earth, and the Lord is going to be glorified by our lives in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. So may the Lord bless you. May the Lord keep you. Share the word of God. Let the church be edified. Tomorrow, I'll be handling the season we are in. I'll be talking about our Kairos moment, and I'll be telling you, as I conclude this topic of manning the gate of your destiny, I'll give you the points and to let you know where we are with the scriptures and what God is expecting of the church right now as a body, not as an individual, in Jesus' name. God bless you. Have yourself a good moment in the presence of the Lord. Thank you, Apostle Michael Afura. God bless you, and other servants of God who are Prophet Simon. May the Lord bless you. Thank you for being an encouragement in my life. I honor the graces of God. God bless you. Have yourself a good moment. Shalom.